And his mother kept all these things in her heart. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our celebration this morning as we honor the Immaculate Heart of Mary. It's been a long tradition for our church, especially with St. John Hughes back in the 12th century, to allow us to recognize first the Sacred Heart of Jesus, how important God's love is for us. And today, this week's following, that we join in Mary's heart to journey with Mary, to accompany by Mary, to approach the throne of God's love and of God's mercy. This wonderful memorial recognizing who Mary is also helps us to see the journey of our devotion toward the Sacred Heart of Jesus being moved and accompanied by Mary. So devotion to the Immaculate Heart of Mary focuses for us this whole area that we are called to respond to God's love, just as Mary responds to Jesus' love in her life. And so Mary becomes that great example of being a motherly love, a mother who cares for her son at all levels of her sacrifices, even to the point of death. And so yesterday, I begin this whole reflection based on St. Clare of Assisi, a quotation where she said, "We become what we love, and who we love shape what we become. That in love, then, the imitation is not a literal mimicking of Christ, rather it means becoming the image of the beloved. An image disclosed through transformations. An image disclosed through transformations." And that truly is a journey of love for all of us. And so I use Dr. Stone, Jim Stone, who is a philosopher, also developed this whole area, the four areas of the self. The first is who am I, as the first person in the realistic of who we are, the actual part of who I am. Second is who do I want to become. It's also focusing on the first person, but now it's the ideal, and we'll explore that further. The third is who do others think I am, and looking at what others' perspective of you and of me in this real, realistic, in this actual of what they perceive us to be. And the fourth is what do others expect me to become? So this third person then is also what is it in your loved one may expect you to become, and you may never reach that goal. And so let us go forth and look at this whole area of transformations of the self. What do I want to become? To move from the actual person that you are, the realistic person that you are, to become the ideal person. Because moving from the actual to the ideal is what makes us becoming creative, allowing us to have that imagination of a better self, and hopefully in that transformation we create a better family and a better world that we live in. And so Dr. Stone then explore in the second portrait of the self in this way as we look at the person, the I. We look at better skills. They would develop learning how to write better, how to add better, how to draw better. We gain more knowledge. Some of you may be in medicine. Your knowledge, you look at the human person, either in mentally or physically, how a person move and develop. For me, my knowledge, the last 20 years of my life, is to explore deeper into the scriptures, deeper into the spirituality of our relationship with the Lord. Third, maybe more, as far as your professionalism, maybe, you can add certain experience to your work so that you can put a beautiful color in your own resume, and that's important. A better body, maybe, where you move from creating a sense of physical look that you want to create for yourself, more masculine or more feminine, however that may be. So Dr. Stone also explored different areas of your interest. Some of you like, for me, the last several years, I like to hike, something I have never done before. Hiking becomes such an exploratory part of my journey with nature. And other of you may have different interests that you may do as you develop through your life. So he asked the question then, why do you want to do this? Why do you create an ideal image for yourself? Again, if you go back to what I said earlier, that when you're looking at this first person as what do I want to become, is you allow yourself to be creative, that you are not static. You are a dynamic individual. You change through times, you adapt with times, and then that's part of the ideal person that's come in. So today in the scripture then, in the Gospel of Luke chapter 2, we look at Jesus Christ. Look at the first person. Who is Jesus? Who am I? As he asked the question, who do you say that I am? And then we look at himself. What do I want to become? And that whole journey of him being 12 years old, being lost in the temple. And so here we see in Luke chapter 2, it says, after 3 days, see, the boys, Jesus, remained in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. So after 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were astounded at his understanding and his answer. So Jesus is looking and asking that deeper question for him, the ideal person, what do I want to become? As he engages the dialogue with the teachers, the scribes and the Pharisees. Again, in areas, explorations into your deeper self. And so here Mary then, listening to the responses of Jesus, sometimes it can be hurtful as a mother, but then yet she listening and absorbing and hears, she said, or listen to what Jesus said. Why are you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my Father's house? But they did not understand what Jesus said to them. He went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them, and his mother kept all these things in herself. So we see the movement of Jesus Christ exploring who am I, and then the ideal person, what do I want to become? As it says here, he went down with Mary and Joseph, came to Nazareth, and was obedient to them. And so it's true with Mary. She kept all these things in her heart. It's a moment of transformation for herself, to becoming with Jesus and like Jesus in part of her journey in obedience to God's will. So I conclude again what St. Augustine asked that question, what does love look like? And I ask you too, what does love look like for you as you explore your very self? So he said, it has the hands to help others, it has the feet to listen to the poor and needy, it has eyes to see misery in one, it has the ears to hear the sight and sorrows of men. That's what love looks like. Your eyes, your ears, your hands, and your feet. So in doing so then, I want to explore to you another step, as Dr. Stone said. In this third phase of the individual self, we move to others. The person, realistically, who do other things I am? So that projection first is coming from inside out, now from outside in. So this third person, realistic part of what do other things that I am, it allows you to create a more self-consciousness of the reflection you give to other people. And that reflection may be real when they come back to you, or it can be all false. And you have to discern where that is. So Dr. Stone said in the third person realistic portrait is our best guess about who other things we are. And since not everyone has the same view of us, this portrait is more a placeholder for the many different third person's perspective. He said, who does he think I am? Who does he think I am? Who do people in general think that I am? So if you have a positive self-image of who you are, whether it's ideal or it's actual, this third person can also create a reaffirming your self-identity, your self-confidence, or can create a lot of self-doubt as well. So let's go forward this day to look at the Immaculate Heart of Mary, but also to look at your eyes, your ears, your hands, and your feet. That is also a projection of who you are and what other people may think of you.